Yes, good morning students. Today we are going to start with the next one, experiment, the second one. So here we are going to form star topology with the five nodes. We are going to send two type of traffic. One is a TCP traffic, another one is a UDP traffic. So we are going to use the four different types of the commands here. So for the TCP connection, we are going to use STCP and RTCP commands, and for the UDP connection, we are going to use the STC and RTC commands. So first open the three terminals here. Okay, in that terminal, first execute a dispatcher. Next one, execute a coordinator. Then execute a NCTNS client. Okay, so here it is that as we have to form the star topology is here. So the network is going to be consisting of a five nodes. So I'm going to take this particular the host here. So first you have to click it on the draw topology. Okay, select the node. So that is 1, 2, 3. So as in the experiment they are given that node 4 should be in the center. So I'm going to selecting this particular the switch. It should be as a node 4. Okay, and next another one is a node 5. So with the help of this link, connect all the computers here in the star topology. Okay, now we have to send information from node 1 to 3 as a TCP here. This is a TCP traffic. So this is the one node 1 is a TCP source and node 3 is a TCP sync here. So now node 2 here is the UDP source will be there, and this is the node 5 is the UDP destination. So go to the edit here. Okay, please choose a file name. So go to the slash user local NCTNS tools lab experiment. Okay, experiment2.tpl. Okay, view the file name experiment2.tpl, click on the save button. Now click on this particular host. Okay, so before that, see what is the IP address here, 1.0.1.3, up there is your. So this is the TCP sync and this is the TCP source. So click on this add a command here. So here the command here which we are going to add is a TCP command here. Okay, so that is a STCP, STCP, view the port number. 7000 is the port number, -l, so this is the size, IP address of the destination machine, 1.0.1.3. Then click on the browse, experiment 2.tpl, click on the button open. Okay, go to the node editor, click on the MAC layer, so it is a full duplex. Now we just see the outgoing packets. Okay. Now come to the node 3. So this is the destination here. That is the TCP sync. So here you have to write RTCP -t 7000 -l 1024. Browse experiment2.tpl. Open. Okay, go to the node editor and the MAC log files, check the incoming packets. Click on the OK button. Now, so this is we have already set up the commands for the TCP traffic, that is from node 1 to node 3. Now we have to set a UDP traffic on this. So here it is a 2 is a the sender source and here it is a destination. So what is the IP address of this? This is 1.0.1.4. So here it is a add the command stg if a new 2.4.1.4 browse experiment2.tpl. Okay, go to the node editor, MAC layer, log files, check the output outgoing packets. Okay,
Now come to the receiver side. R. So this is the RDG iPhone U from W log 1. Browse experiment to open MAC layer. So that is a incoming packets. Okay. Click on the OK button. Now after this, click on the R, run the simulation. Yes. Go to the simulation and run it.
Okay, we'll see the result of this simulation as I already done on experiment, and already that simulation file is ready for watching. I'm just going to show you that how it looks that after the simulation is done. Okay, the similar experiment.
Simulation is completed here. Okay, file transfer done. So now you will just play this. Now you are going to see the simulation here. Okay, now yes, the data is transmitting from node 1 to 3 and it is from that node 2 to render host. Here I have given it as a node 4. So this node 1 to 3, so this is here, this line is of TCP and here this line is of UDP. Okay, so now here you have to plot the graph here. Okay, now plot the graph, file, open. Okay, results. So here you are having all these are there. This is a node 2, node 3, node 4, node 3 output throughput is there. Okay, node 3 is in.
So as in the first half, as you know that we have given the name of the experiment as a experiment 2.tpl. okay, so after the end of that the simulation, okay, so it will take a lot of time for conversion of that file transfer. So as I already showing you one of the file which is a simulation is completed. Okay, here you just see that how you are going to plot the graph. So this is the same experiment, that is here the name of the file is experiment 2.tpl. okay, when you go into this that experiment 2.results file, inside that whatever the result you wanted to analyze, you have been already selected over there, that is output throughput of the node, input throughput of the receiver side. Okay, so you just select which one you wanted to see it in the graph, which you wanted to plot a graph, you select it and then automatically it is going to be displayed in the graph. So in this experiment, so here it is here it is a node 4 is a host here. Okay, so don't be make any confusion here. Okay, it is just the number here which it has been assigned here, that is compared to the first half. Okay,
throughput, if you click, now it is going to show that one. File, new graph 1. Okay, so you just open, that is a node 2 and now it is node 3.
So in this way here you can plot the as many number of that graphs you want, that is for the collision. Okay, if you want to plot the graph for the drop of that particular packets. Okay, similarly for the output throughput and the input throughputs. So whatever the data you wanted to analyze, okay, so initially before that simulation you have to select that whether you wanted to go for analyzing the drop of the packets or the collision here. Okay, in between the two traffics, that is the TCP and the UDP. Okay, so at the end of that, once the simulation is going to be completed, you are going to get the results over there. And during the execution of the simulation, you just click on the play button. At that time only you plot the graphs over there, and you people are able to view the graphs on the screen. Okay, thank you very much.